video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I prep my hair before I get a silk press. So right now my hair is looking crazy because I just came back from the pool and I got my hair wet and everything, because usually I don't, but I did this time because I knew I was going to be doing my hair. So I have it in this crazy looking bun. And I'm gonna just wash my hair because I'm getting ready to get my hair done by a hairdresser. I'm going to clarify my hair with some shampoo. So my favorite prep shampoo is the Paul Mitchell shampoo to clarify and remove buildup. I wash my hair twice with this and the Tea Tree Special shampoo invigorating cleanser. I honestly think this is also a line by Paul Mitchell, but yeah, I wash my hair once with this. So I clarify a total of 3 times. All right, so this is how my hair is looking. I'm gonna just take these. I have 2 braids in the front, so I'm taking them out. But yeah, this is my hair. No product in it, well, kind of no product in it. It has a little bit of product in it, but mostly pool water. So yeah, I'm gonna get started washing, and yeah, I'll be back. All right, guys, so I'm out. Woo! Wow, look at this shrinkage, though. Like, no, absolutely not. Let's just section my hair off. Okay guys, so gonna get a water bottle, a regular water bottle. We're gonna next do a protein treatment, a 2-step protein treatment. I always do this before I get my hair slick pressed because I'm having somebody else do my hair. They use heat, you know, it gets real silky. Now she doesn't use high heat, she only goes up to like I think 410. So it's not like it's crazy high, like 450 or anything crazy, but I always like to do a protein treatment before just to like, you know, protect my hair and keep it protected while I'm getting heat added to it. And I think like the prepping that I do, and also the after, I mean, I have a video on that already. The aftercare that I do after I come back from a silk press has kept my hair from getting heat damage. I've been going to this hairdresser since November. So this will be like, I think my 8th time. Is it my 8th? November. My fifth time going to her, and I have yet to get heat damage. So yeah, so I'm just gonna pour this treatment into a water bottle because it just helps it better distribute the treatment. I used to try to just like pour the bottle itself on my hair and I ended up like making a mess and I'm wasting product. So I always like to pour it in here, and whatever I don't use, I just pour it back into the bottle when I'm done. But I just pour like a good amount that I think I'll need. And this is the, says 2-step torching treatment, stops hair breakage, rebuilds hair structure for 6 weeks. Ideal for processed or natural hair. Obviously my hair's natural, but I do put heat on it. So this helps. And I guess I do use this every, I would not say every 6 weeks, but probably every 8 to 10 weeks, because I get my hair trimmed every 2 months. The next time I would do this is the next time I would get my hair trimmed. So about 8 weeks, I would say. So I just put a towel on because it can be messy. And I'll get started on this section. Oh, I'm getting to the front. You have to leave it out because it's supposed to get hard. When I sit under the hood of dryer, it's gonna get really like rock hard, and you're not supposed, like, you can touch it while it's wet, you can comb it or whatever while it's wet, but like when it's drying, it gets extremely hard, and you are, it says it on the bottle, like, do not touch your hair while it's driving, because it was drying, because you will break your hair off, basically, because it just gets, the protein hardens on your hair, or in your hair, whatever, and it becomes extremely hard, so you just gotta leave it alone. But right now, I'm just sectioning pieces. Ugh, my hair is so freaking, like, tangled, because every time I'm used to using the moisturizing shampoo, and, you know, deep conditioning right after I shampoo. So I have to be extra careful when I'm doing my hair because it doesn't have any product in it. So it's very dry and very shrunken. So I just have to be very careful. And just spray this stuff on like so. I detangle because I don't want to come out of this with a matted bird's nest. So I always detangle while it's wet. And then I go ahead and leave it alone after that. Looking, the back is starting to, it's not really drying because it's not hard yet, but I'm gonna send it to the hood dryer and I'll show you how my hair looks when I'm out from under the hood dryer. Okay guys, I'm back. This thing is hard as a rock. I mean, like, hard as a freaking rock. The shrinkage is real. I'm gonna do a little 360 for y'all to show you how my hair looks. It looks absolutely insanely crazy. Like, girl, it is so hard. Like, so yeah, this is the protein treatment. I sat under the hood dryer for like, let me see. I think it was like 20 minutes, maybe 15, I don't know. As you're supposed to sit under a hood dryer or like some heat until it's hard. A couple pieces down here are still a little wet, but it's okay. I'm not tripping about that. I'm not gonna trip about that. I'm gonna go ahead and wash this out and deep condition. The deep conditioner I'll be using, well, you have to use, it's a two-step treatment, so you have to use the balancing moisturizer with this to give your hair, put your hair back in pH balance. Otherwise, your hair gonna be crazy, so probably hella freaking shedding. So yeah, I'm gonna be using this, and then I'm gonna be using a deep conditioner on top of this. This is the deep conditioner I'll be using at Love Miche. This is the Strengthen Protein Moisture Balance, so it's all about the protein right now. This is the moisture, this is the protein. I'll be sitting under a hood, my steamer for like 30 minutes, and then I'll show you guys how I style and prep for my silk press. Hey y'all, so I'm back. My hair is in some deep conditioner. It's in that moisturizer stuff I told you and the deep conditioner. My tan's really starting to come through now. I'm gonna sit under my steamer. It is on right now, I'm waiting for the steam to come out. I'm gonna sit under that for like 30 minutes. And then after that, I'm gonna rinse this out with some green tea, and I'll explain why I use that in a little bit. I've made a video about it before, but to update you guys, just in case you guys don't know why I do it, I'll tell you why when I get to that part. So yeah, my hair is in some deep conditioner. Gonna let it settle in, and I'll be back. My bad, I got too excited and forgot to show you guys how I rinse my hair with green tea. But basically, I just like fill a pot up with, I have a water filter, so I just fill up a pot with pure filtered water. I take two green tea bags, I steep them until it's like very, very green. I rinse my hair with water, like I rinse all the like conditioner out completely. And then after I finish rinsing everything out, I just do one last rinse with the green tea. I just pour it on my head and make sure it reaches like my scalp. And what that does is that like green tea has caffeine in it. And like you could use black tea. I think black tea is like stronger, but I have like naturally medium brown hair, and black tea will dye your hair darker. I don't want it to get my hair darker, so I just use green tea, which is like has, I would say, good results because my hair is very thick. And every time I go to the hairdresser, she always tells me, because when I first started going to the hairdresser, she told me like I need to like eat more almonds, take more keratin. Like, she was telling me like right here, my hair was like thinner than the rest of my hair, and so I was like, oh no. Like, so I started so I started taking biotin with keratin, not biotin with keratin, was it biotin with collagen? It's like the liquid drops or whatever. I put that under my tongue for like 20 seconds. I take that, and then I started doing green tea again. I've been doing this since November. I rinse it, I do that rinse every time I wash my hair, and every time I go, she's like, oh my god, your hair is like thicker, your hair is thicker, your hair is thicker. So my hair is very, very, very thick. My hair is thick, girl. So If you want thicker hair, green tea, just rinse it on the last rinse and then don't wash it out. Just like when you're done rinsing all the product out, your hair is fully rinsed, do one last rinse with the green tea, and then you just wring your hair out. And my hair is still pretty damp. I don't like towel dried or anything. I just wring it out, and now I'm about to style it. Basically, what I'm gonna do now is just braid it up into chunky braids just so that it's easy to take down when I go to get my hair shaved. It's easier to take down when I go to get my hair like washed and set or whatever. So I just take the braids out and my hair is easy to wash. And I don't over use product because I want her to easily be able to wash my hair and not have a product buildup because she's gonna silk press it. So, but I have to put some type of product in my hair, otherwise my hair will get dry. The product I will be using is this Camille Rose Curl Love Moisture Milk. It's very lightweight, does the job. Now I'm running out. I don't know if this will be enough, but let me see, what else do I have? Luckily, I have Camille Rose Almond J Butter, Twisting Butter. Now this is a little heavier than this, but maybe I'll mix it or something so it won't be as heavy, because I don't think this is gonna be enough for my whole head. So I'm probably gonna mix these together so it'll be like a light, small, medium hold. Not hold, but like moisture, level of moisture. And today's Sunday night. My hair appointment's on Tuesday, so I like to braid my hair 2 days before. So I just braid it and I'll wear it out tomorrow on braids. And then I'll go on Tuesday and get my hair done and she'll just rewash it and set it and it's silky smooth. So I'll have you guys watch me do that. Hey guys, welcome back. Today is the day of getting my hair done. So it is day two. I've had my hair in braids, so I'll show you my real quick. I'm about to go, but show you real quick how I go to the hairdresser. So I told you guys I put my hair in like some chunky braids, put in a high bun, and then I'm just gonna go there with a scarf. Also too, I like to bring things with me on my way to the hairdresser. I always leave the hair salon with a wrap. I never walk out with free flowing hair ever. I always have a wrap it. So I bring another scarf, not this one, because the hair I have on it is has like product in it. Like, you know, I showed you I put some moisturizer in my hair. I don't want any moisturizer on my scarves because then my hair will get oily faster. So I get a brand new clean scarf. I usually like to wash my scarves for my straight hair twice to make sure there's no oil, because I use so much oil on my hair. So there's no oil in it. And then I bring a bonnet, and then I bring this thing I have called a hairbrella. It's basically like a hat umbrella thing that I use just in case it rains, because you know it loves to rain when you get your hair done. So I always bring that everywhere I go with my hair straight, because I'm not playing with this weather. So yeah, and I always bring a wide tooth comb. I always make sure to clean it like with alcohol so there's no oil on it. And I always bring a brush, a hair brush, and a paddle brush. Paddle brush is to like, you know, kind of like, I don't know, paddle brush helps me get the hair around my head, and a smooth brush, like bristle brush, helps me keep it up. And then I put my scarf on. So let me show you that real quick. Okay, so my paddle brush, my bristle brush, is one soft side and one hard side. I have a clean wide tooth comb and I make sure everything's clean from the last time. This is my scarf. This is the scarf I always use when I have my hair straight. That way it doesn't get like too much oil in it, because oil does build up in scarves even if I wash it. So that's like my straight hair scarf. And then this is my bonnet. I do use this on my curly hair, but it should be okay. I washed it a couple times. And then this is my hair umbrella. You see it has like a thing, so if it rains, the rain hits this and drips off. And this type of material like is like a duck, kind of like a duck's like feathers. It just like washes off of this. Like it's, I don't know, water resistant basically. Inside is satin. So yeah, it's made to protect straight hair from wetness. How I bring it to my hairdresser appointment. And yeah, so I'll be back with straight hair. See you guys soon. Hey guys, so I'm back. So this is my hair and I can make this silk press probably last. Well, it's summertime, so maybe a week, but oh shit. Maybe not. I don't know, I'm sweating it out already just having it out. So I'm gonna go wrap this girl up real quick. And yeah, that's how I prep my hair for a silk press. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you guys next one. Bye.